Ready? Start.
Yes, friends, this is my first visit to this country and my contact with it is brief, and you do not expect me to speak much about the problems which you are facing. I thought there were two points in which I had some relationship with this part of the world. We are members of the conference and we have some residents of Indian origin in this country. These two things bring us together. As for the conference, I notice in the press that your Prime Minister is trying to get our republic full status in the Commonwealth. Status is something desirable. When we talk about the conference, we are reminded of certain ideals which bind the peoples of our countries together. The member nations are fully free, absolutely independent. They share no allegiance, but they share loyalty to ideals. They have a common spirit of compromise, getting things adjusted by mutual discussion and agreement, equality before the law for all citizens. Some of these things are the important features which bind the different members together. No decisions are adopted in the Prime Minister's conference which restrict the liberty of action of the members, but the discussions help to bring about a better understanding. So far as the ideals of the unity are concerned, they insist on the extension of democratic principles to all peoples which belong to the conference, wherever they may be. It attempts to achieve a harmony of mind and spirit among those who belong to the conference. There may be difficulties, but the goal is clear, and without haste and without rest, it is the duty of all of us who belong to the conference to work for those great ideals. We talk about peaceful coexistence. The concept of active peaceful coexistence, it affects not merely international relations, but it also has a bearing on domestic relations, also on national problems. And if a policy of peaceful active coexistence is promoted in countries which have their own problems to face, there is no doubt that we will be able to reach the goal. But this peaceful policy requires a larger understanding, a wider imagination. Unless we develop a different outlook altogether, this peaceful coexistence cannot function either in the national or in the international field. This very concept of Panchsila was enunciated 2500 years ago by the Buddha in a different way. Stop.